Hey guys, Nick Drossos, and welcome to Code Red Defense. We've got a question. Is Nick, how do I defend myself against a beer bottle, right? So obviously this is not a real one, but this shit's dangerous. I've seen it in fights. I've seen it smash over people's face. I've had it thrown. You're working in the club and you're just throwing bottles and you're like fucking bobbing and weaving that shit. And you just hear, especially when it's hitting the bar and shit. And I've seen it smashed on guys' heads. And like all the little glass going to the head. So it's a dangerous weapon. And if you're at a bar or a club, it's everywhere, right? You have a beer, you have a weapon. But like when it's broken, it actually, you know, it's no different than a knife, right? It could be used as overhand, or a lot of times they'll use it this way and come in. Now, the dangerous part of this as well, when you're thinking about it, you gotta think of the environment. You're in a club, you're in a bar, you're drunk. There's lights, there's sound, you can't hear, you can't see as clear. And I was talking with Davis, actually. I was training him, he was an MMA fighter, and there was a big fight at a club, and he's like, oh, you know, musique, light, and he's the guy, the fight completely changes. You don't have clarity, you don't know who's who sometimes. All you're doing at that very moment, if you work in a club as a security, is you're trying to save your ass first. You're looking out for your partners and your team, but at the same time, you're like, fuck it, right now, all I'm looking for is don't get stabbed, don't get shot, don't get sucker punched, don't go on the ground. That's it, that's all. So when we look at knife defense, this again, we looked at scissor, we looked at different weapons. There's no different than a beer bottle, right? I'm not gonna treat the beer bottle differently than I'm gonna treat a knife. The concept is the same, that if he were to attack, I'll be, boom, I'm gonna come in here, I'm gonna jab it. I'm gonna jam it, I'm gonna strike as quickly as possible. If he's going low, I'm gonna come in, I'm gonna try to trap and strike as quickly as possible. The idea, again, is for you to intercept as quickly as possible the weapon. Now, when you're looking at the weapon, when you look at a hand, right, as soon as you see this, if you see this or this, chances he's holding something. You might not see it because you're under adrenaline. You might not even feel it because you're under adrenaline. But this is not a punch. If the guy's doing this, he's obviously gonna be throwing punches and headhunting. If you feel this kind of rotation motion here or here, if the person grabs and he's doing this, you gotta be very aware that chances are he's holding on something and he's trying to stab you. So your awareness has to kick in. Again, there's only so much I can talk about this, but I'm trying to like put it in here that when I'm faced with my attacker and I see a clenched fist, a weapon, him hiding something, angling off, I can only assume there's a weapon involved. I don't want to find out what weapon it is. I want to strike him before that weapon either comes out or starts getting momentum into striking. So if I'm here and I can't see this, and if I see this, I'm striking right away. I'm not going to let him get close and be like, oh, what is that? Oh, it's a bottle. No, I see this, I bam, bam, he's fucking coming in right away because I don't want to take the slightest chance of him building momentum, being able to strike, creating the distance that he needs for his weapon. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you want to learn more self-defense, guys, we have a weapons video. I love this video. We cover more in depth the beer bottle, golf stick, hockey stick, all hammer, all kinds of short, medium, and long range weapons. We'll put the link in the comment box. I want to thank you guys for watching. Stay safe and stand strong.